A very good morning to all of you. Today I'm going to continue the next topic, that is MTP, means medical termination of pregnancy. Now, what do you mean by the term medical termination of pregnancy? It is defined as a voluntarily or intentional termination of pregnancy before the full term, and in common language it is known as abortion. So jab kabhi bhi koi couple ya koi person full time means jo hamara gestation period hota hai, that is of 9 months, 9 months se pehle, full term se pehle jo abortion karata hai apni marzi se, that is known as MTP or medical termination of pregnancy, right? So it was legalized by the government in the year 1971 by the Indian government to under the strict conditions so as to avoid the misuse of medical termination of pregnancy. Nowadays it is quite impossible in hospitals for MTP because it is done only under the following situation. First one is the failure of the contraceptive used during the coitus. In some of the cases, if the couples are using, they are using contraceptive and there is a failure and there is an unwanted pregnancy and they don't want the next child, in that case it is only allowed. When continued pregnancy is harmful or fatal either for the mother or for the baby or for the both, then it is terminated. कई बार क्या होता है कि ड्यूरिंग सम कॉम्प्लिकेशन प्रेगनेंसी में अगर कोई कॉम्प्लिकेशन आ जाए तो इट इज़ डेंजरस फॉर द मदर एंड और फॉर द बेबी एंड फॉर द बोथ. तो इन सच केसेस इट इज़ टर्मिनेटेड. देन इन द केसेस ऑफ द रेप केसेस, द रेप केसेस इन इंडिया आर वेरी कॉमन एंड इन द केस ऑफ द रेप केस द पर्सन इज अलाउड, द फीमेल इज अलाउड टू टर्मिनेट हर प्रेगनेंसी. सो इट इज़ सेफ ड्यूरिंग द फर्स्ट ट्राइमेस्टर, मीन्स अप टू द 12th week of pregnancy. So next is the sexually transmitted diseases, that is STDs. Yes. So it is known as sexually transmitted diseases. Now what are STDs? As clear from the name, these are the diseases that are transmitted during the sexual intercourse from the one person to the another, and this is known as sexually transmitted disease. It is also known as VDs, that is venereal disease. They are also known as RTI, that is reproductive tract infection. So these include some of the disease like gonorrhea, syphilis, genital herpes, genital warts, hepatitis B, and the most common is the HIV. What are the now? What are the early symptoms? The early symptoms that are found in the time of the sexual disease. So one should be very careful if a person is having this type of disease. These the common are symptoms are the itching, then is the fluid discharge, slight pain, swelling in the genital organs. If a person found any of these disease, then these are the early symptoms of the STDs. What are the complications due to the chronic STDs? Chronic means if they are for the long term. अगर ये STDs long term के लिए चल जाते हैं, आप इनकी केयर नहीं करते, आप कोई प्रॉपर ट्रीटमेंट नहीं लेते, then they become chronic, and for chronic STDs you will have PID complications. You may get PID, that is pelvic inflammatory disease, right? Then they may cause abortion, they may cause stillbirths, they may cause abortions. Stillbirth means the when the baby is born, it is not alive, it is known as stillbirth. Then they may have ecotopic pregnancies. Ecotopic pregnancies means the pregnancy in the fallopian tube. The pregnancy occurs in the fallopian tube. It may lead to the infertility, means the couple is not able to reproduce. It may lead to the infertility. And last is, it may cause the cancer in the genital regions. It may cause cancer in the reproductive tract or the genital regions. So transmission of the hepatitis B and HIV occurs in the following ways. Normally we said HIV and hepatitis B, they are the STDs, but the disease that are not only caused during the physical contact, during the sexual intercourse, they can also be occurred by the sharing of the injections, needles, surgical instrument with the infected person, transfusion of infected blood, or from the infected mother to the fetus through the placenta. So these are also some of the ways in which the hepatitis B and HIV can occur. So next is the simple principles or the things that we use to avoid STDs. How STDs can be prevented? Prevention of STDs. Now these can be prevented by taking the proper hygienic care, avoiding sex with the unknown partners and the multiple partners, always use condoms while coitus, and contact a qualified doctor if you have any early stage of infection. So this can be controlled by taking the proper preventive measures. So let's recall what again is the sexually transmitted diseases. These are the diseases that are transmitted from one partner to the another at the time of the sexual intercourse. They are also known as VD, that is venereal diseases, or RTIs, that is reproductive tract infection. They include gonorrhea, syphilis, genital herpes, genital warts, hepatitis B and HIV. Early symptoms are the itching, fluid discharge, slight pain and swelling in the genital organs. Sometimes if we don't take care at the early stage, these disease may become the chronic disease, and they may cause the complications like the pelvic inflammatory diseases, abortion, stillbirth, infertility, ecotopic pregnancies, and the cancer of the reproductive tract. Moreover, HIV and hepatitis B, they are transmitted not only by the sexual intercourse, they are transmitted by sharing the injections, needle, and any surgical instrument of the infected person. They are also transmitted from the transfusion of the infected blood, and they are also transmitted from the infected mother to the newborn, to the fetus, to the placenta. So simple measures to prevent STDs are: avoid sex with the unknown partners, take proper hygienic care, multiple partners, always use condom while coitus, and contact a qualified doctor if a person is having any early symptoms. So this is all about the STDs. In the next lecture, we will discuss about the infertility. Thank you, students. That's all for today.